Hello and welcome to the Smiling Signs Auslan resource. The topic of this video is tooth decay and preventive treatment. Click on the timestamp in the description below to be taken to the relevant topic you would like to learn more about. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to learn more about oral health. The first topic is tooth structure. The mouth is split into four corners: the upper left, upper right, lower left, and lower right. These are known as quadrants. Adults have 32 permanent teeth. There are four types of teeth in the adult mouth. Let's look at each type. Incisors are the front four teeth on the upper and lower jaws. They are the most visible teeth when smiling. The teeth in the middle are called central incisors, and next to them are the lateral incisors. Next to the lateral incisors are the canines. They are used to tear foods apart. Further back are the premolar and molar teeth. They are used for chewing. There are two premolar and three molar teeth in each quadrant. The third molar teeth are also called wisdom teeth. Sometimes these teeth are missing or cannot fit in the mouth and may need to be removed. Children have 20 baby teeth. They only have incisors, canines, and molars. Permanent adult teeth replace baby teeth as children grow. Even though baby teeth eventually come out, they are still very important. Let's discuss different parts of the tooth. The part of the tooth that you can see in the mouth is called the crown. The root is the part of the tooth that sits under the gums and holds the tooth in the jawbone. Teeth have two main layers called enamel and dentine. Enamel is the white, hard outside layer that covers the crown of the tooth. Damage to enamel does not cause pain. Dentine is located inside the enamel and is more yellow in colour. Damage to dentine can cause pain or sensitivity. The enamel and dentine protect the nerve and blood vessels in the middle of the tooth. This is called the pulp. The teeth are held in place by bone. The bone and some parts of the teeth are covered by gums. So what is tooth decay? Millions of bacteria live in the mouth. These bacteria can form a sticky layer on the teeth called plaque. Sugar from foods and drinks feed these bacteria. The sugar gives the bacteria energy to make acid. If the acid and plaque are not brushed away, over time they can cause tooth decay. Protecting teeth from tooth decay is a balancing act. When the factors that cause tooth decay are greater than the factors that protect the teeth, this means that tooth decay can occur. Things that protect the teeth include saliva, a low-sugar diet, fluoride, brushing, and cleaning between the teeth every day. Things that can increase the risk of tooth decay include a dry mouth, sugary drinks, snacking, a high sugar diet, and poor oral hygiene. The next few slides have some graphic images. We will discuss what happens if tooth decay is not treated. Tooth decay starts as a white spot on the tooth. If the tooth decay is not treated, it can make a hole in the tooth. If the hole is not treated, the decay can get bigger and the tooth may become sore or even break. If the decay gets into the tooth's nerve or pulp, the germs can cause an infection. Tooth decay often does not cause pain until it's severe, so you might not even know that you have it. Next, we will discuss ways that tooth decay can be treated. The treatment of tooth decay depends on how much decay is present. Tooth decay can be prevented by brushing, flossing, and eating a low-sugar diet. Early tooth decay can be stopped when it is a white spot. This is often done using fluoride. Most tooth decay can be fixed with a filling. Some badly broken down teeth may need extra treatments, such as a dental crown. If a tooth needs to be removed, your dentist will tell you about the different ways to fill the space. This video will only focus on preventive treatments. Find out more information about these other options in other Smiling Signs videos. There are many things you can do at home to prevent tooth decay. Bacteria in the mouth form a sticky film on the teeth called plaque. Brushing your teeth twice a day cleans the plaque from the teeth. If the plaque is not brushed away, it becomes hard. Hard plaque is called calculus and cannot easily be brushed off the teeth. Calculus needs to be cleaned off by a dentist. Toothbrushes with soft bristles are the best choice. Electric toothbrushes can also help you brush better. Make sure you reach all tooth surfaces when you're brushing. You can also gently brush the top of your tongue. Learn more about toothbrushing in our other Smiling Signs videos. Children and adults are recommended to use fluoride toothpaste. The fluoride helps to protect the teeth from tooth decay. After brushing, spit out the toothpaste, but do not rinse your mouth with water. Do not swallow the toothpaste. Children can start to use toothpaste at 18 months. In Australia, children's toothpaste has less fluoride. Children 6 and above can start to use adult toothpaste. Adults should help children brush until they are 9 years old. It is important to not forget to clean in between your teeth. Common options to clean these surfaces include flossing and using interdental brushes. Make sure you clean between your teeth at least once a day. Start cleaning between kids' teeth once they have teeth touching side by side. Fluoride is used to protect teeth and to make them stronger. A dentist can put a fluoride treatment on the teeth that are at risk of getting tooth decay or white spots. After fluoride treatment, your dentist may ask you to avoid eating or drinking for a period of time to help it work better. Fissure sealants are another way your dentist can protect teeth from germs that cause tooth decay. All back teeth have grooves called fissures. Some of these grooves are very deep, and this may cause food and germs to get stuck. These grooves may be so deep that it can be hard to clean them out, even with good brushing. Fissure sealants fill up these grooves, so that germs cannot get inside and cause tooth decay. Fissure sealants may be white, clear, or sometimes even pink. They are commonly used to protect the back teeth of kids and teenagers. Some benefits of fissure sealants are that the dentist doesn't need to cut away the tooth, and the tooth doesn't need to be made numb. Placing a fissure sealant may help to prevent tooth decay from developing. Approximately 2 in 3 fissure sealants are still in place and preventing tooth decay after 9 years. Fissure sealants may not always prevent tooth decay. They can break or wear away over time, so it's important to regularly go to the dentist to get them checked. Teeth with fissure sealants still need to be brushed every day.